Good morning, my dear students. How things are going? In the previous class, we were discussed about the fundamental unit of life. Which is the fundamental unit of life? Yes, cells are the fundamental unit of life. And we also learned about unicellular organisms and multicellular organisms. In unicellular organisms, all different life processes are carried out by a single cell. But in the case of multicellular organisms, all their life processes are carried out by different cells. That means they have specialized cells for different activities. And we also learned that we have different kinds of cells. The shape and size of the cell depends upon the specific function that the cell performs. If we study a cell under a microscope, we can see that almost three features are same for every cell. The three features are plasma membrane, nucleus and cytoplasm. We can see these three features are common for every cell. And different activities that are taking place in the cells are carried out by these features, and it also helps the cells to communicate with its surrounding. We can learn about the outermost covering of the cell, which is the cell membrane or plasma membrane. Cell membrane or plasma membrane is the outermost covering of the cell, and it helps to separate the content of the cell from its external environment. It also helps for the transfer or movement of some materials into the cell and out of the cell. Plasma membrane, it permits the entry and exit of only some materials. And it also prevents the movement of some molecules into the cells and away from the cell. That is why it is called selectively permeable membrane or semi-permeable membrane. Then, the plasma membrane is a flexible membrane. That means it can change its shape. In some organisms like unicellular organisms like amoeba, they are capturing their food by using this flexibility. They are called endocytosis. Endocytosis is the process, the flexibility of the plasma membrane. It is the flexibility of the plasma membrane to engulf the food is called endocytosis. And this plasma membrane is made up of organic substances called lipids and proteins. Here you can see picture of a cell. Then which will be this part, the outermost covering of the cell, that is the cell membrane or plasma membrane. Inside the cell you can see a spherical structure, that is the nucleus. And between the nucleus and cell membrane, we can see jelly-like substance, that is the fluid substance, that is the cytoplasm. Then, now we can learn how the materials like oxygen, carbon dioxide and water are transported through cell membrane. Okay, we already learned that cell membrane is a selectively permeable membrane or semi-permeable membrane. Why we call the cell membrane as semi-permeable membrane? Because it allows the entry and exit of only some materials through it. Okay. So the substances like oxygen, carbon dioxide and water, they are exchanging through a process called diffusion. Do you know what is diffusion? I think you already learned in your previous chapter. Diffusion is the movement of molecules from a higher concentration region to a lower concentration region through a semi-permeable membrane. What is diffusion? Diffusion is the movement of molecules from a higher concentration region to lower concentration region through a semi-permeable membrane. That process is called diffusion. So diffusion plays an important role for the transport of materials into the cell and away from the cell. We can check how it is taking place. So in the case of oxygen, the concentration of oxygen is higher in the external environment of the cell and the concentration of oxygen is lower inside the cell. So what will happen? These oxygen molecules will move from higher concentration region to lower concentration region through this semi-permeable membrane. In this way, the oxygen is entered into the cell and cells will utilize this oxygen for its different activities, for carrying out different activities. Then as a result of different metabolic activities, they are producing the waste product, that is carbon dioxide. Actually, carbon dioxide is a cellular waste. Cells want to release it or remove it. Then here the concentration of carbon dioxide is more inside the cell and it is low in outside the cell. Then what happened? The carbon dioxide will move from a higher concentration region to lower concentration region. That means it will move from inside the cell to outside. Okay, so this process is called diffusion. So diffusion plays an important role for the transport of gases like oxygen and carbon dioxide. Then water also transported the same way. Then through the water, some minerals are dissolved. So when the water is transported, along with the water, this minerals also transported. Then we can learn how it is taking place. The movement of water molecules from a higher concentration region to lower concentration region is called diffusion, not diffusion, that is osmosis. Is that osmosis? Osmosis is the movement of water molecules from a higher concentration region to a lower concentration region through a semi-permeable or selectively permeable membrane. Okay. So, in the case of water, we call this diffusion. Instead of diffusion, we are calling osmosis. Okay. So, water molecules. In the case of, if the concentration of water is higher in the external environment, what happens? These water molecules will move from external environment to the into the cell through a semi-permeable membrane through a process called osmosis. It's fine. Then, if the concentration of water molecules inside the cell is high, what happens? These water molecules will move from the cell to this external environment that through a semi-permeable membrane. That process is also known as osmosis. Now we can check what happens if we place some plant cell or animal cell in hypotonic solution, isotonic solution and hypertonic solution. Let's watch it. Now we can do an activity. For this activity, I take some raisins. Can you see the raisins here? Okay, then I will put these raisins into a glass of water. Then we can check what happened to this raisin after some times. Okay, we can wait for some times. Now let's have a look into the surface of raisin. How it is? Is it swollen? No, it is shrinked. That means the concentration of water inside the raisin is very low.
because there is no water or little water is present inside the rising. Okay, when we put the rising into the water, what happened? The water will move from higher concentration region to lower concentration region. That is, the concentration of water molecule is higher in this external environment or in the glass. Then the concentration of water is low in rising. So the water will move from the glass to the rising through the semi-permeable membrane. That process is the osmosis. Okay. Then after some times, our rising will swell in. If the medium surrounding the cell has a higher water concentration than the cell, meaning that the outside solution is very dilute, the cell will gain water by osmosis. Such solution is known as hypotonic solution. Here I keep the rising in hypotonic solution. That means the concentration of the water is more. Okay. I didn't add anything into this water. Okay. Now we can check what happens to the rising if we put the rising in an isotonic solution. That means the rising, both the rising and the surrounding media has same concentration of water. If I dip or keep the swollen rising into this water, what happen? There will be the movement of water molecules in both sides, but we can't able to see or observe any change. Okay, because the concentration of water inside and outside the cell is same. Such solutions are called isotonic solution. So you have learned hypertonic solution, hypotonic solution and isotonic solution. You can do this activity in your home too, and you can observe it. Okay. Now I take some water in a glass. Now the water is hypotonic. That means I didn't add anything to it. That means the concentration of water molecule is high here. Then I am going to add some salt into it. Then what happened? Here the concentration of salt is higher than the water molecules. Now our solution turned or changed into hypertonic solution. What happened? Now let's we can check what happened if we keep a cell or swollen cell into this hypertonic solution. Now I wish to keep the swollen rising into this hypertonic solution. Here I have the swollen rising. I'm going to add this rising into this hypertonic solution. Then we can observe after some times what happened to this rising. Here the concentration of water is high in inside the rising when compared to the outside. Then the concentration of water is low in outside or external environment because we add some salt into it. Then after some time, what happened to our rising? The rising will lose its water into the surrounding. That means water will move from a higher concentration region to lower concentration region. So the risings will shrink. Now, after some times, I take the rising from the hypertonic solution. What you observe? What you can see? Yes, the rising is shrinked or it loses its water. Okay, this process is the osmosis.
In plant cells, in addition to plasma membrane, they have another rigid structure, that is cell wall. Okay. So So cell wall, here you can see the cell wall. Cell wall is present in plant cell. It is absent in animal cell. In addition to plasma membrane or cell membrane, plant cells have another rigid membrane, that is the cell wall. This cell wall is made up of cellulose. Cellulose is a complex substance. It provides structural strength to the plant. Okay, so cell wall is an additional wall or membrane to the plant cell. It provides structural strength to plant. It is made up of cellulose. So fine. Here you can see a picture of plant cell. Suppose it is a living cell. If we keep this living cell in a hypertonic solution, that means for in a salt solution, hypertonic solution or salt solution, what happen? The cell will lose its water, or the water molecules from the cell will move from a higher concentration region to lower concentration region. Then what happened? This cell membrane or plasma membrane will shrink. You can see the plasma membrane or cell membrane will shrink because it lost its water. So it will shrink away from the cell wall. This process is called plasmolysis. What is plasmolysis? So, if we keep a living plant cell in a hypertonic solution, the plant cell will lose its water through a process of osmosis. Then, the cell membrane and other substances will shrink away from the cell wall. This process is called plasmolysis. Only living cells can absorb water by osmosis. Dead cells can't able to absorb water by osmosis. Okay, only living cells can absorb water by osmosis. So, what are the things that we learn here? We learn about cell wall. Cell wall is an additional membrane above the plasma membrane or cell membrane. We can see the cell wall in plants, fungi and bacteria. This cell wall protects the cell from the bursting if the cells are in a hypotonic medium. The next one is nucleus. Nucleus is a spherical structure. And the nucleus is covered with a double-layered membrane, that is called nuclear membrane. So many tiny holes are seen in nuclear membrane. They will help to transport materials from the nucleus to its surrounding. Now we can talk about cytoplasm. Okay. Cytoplasm is the fluid content inside the plasma membrane. We can see the cytoplasm between the plasma membrane and nucleus. Then it is the fluid content inside the plasma membrane. So many cell organelles are found in cytoplasm. Okay. And in your previous class, you have learned about eukaryotic cell and prokaryotic cell.
All cells have a cell membrane, which separates the inside of the cell from its environment. Cytoplasm, which is a jelly-like fluid, and DNA, which is the cell's genetic material.
Inside the nucleus, we can see chromosomes.
There are two broad categories of cells.
For inheritance of features,
the first category is eukaryotic cells.
In the form of
they
DNA.
Have organelles, which
DNA
include the nucleus and other
the
special
information
parts.
Necessary for constructing
eukaryotic
and
cells
organizing
are more advanced, complex cells, such as
DNA
those found in plants and animals.
Genes. Any cell which
the
is
second
not
category
varying,
is prokaryotic
is
cells.
As a part
they
of
don't have a nucleus or membrane-enclosed
the
organelles.
Start to
they
divide,
do have genetic
material
but it's not contained within a nucleus. Prokaryotic cells are always one-celled or unicellular organisms, such as bacteria.
Only nucleic acid and is called nucleoid.
So, what are organelles?
Organelle
means little organ.
Hence, they are called prokaryotic.
Organelles are the specialized parts of a cell that have unique jobs to perform. Let's start with the nucleus, the control center of the cell. The nucleus contains DNA, or genetic material. DNA dictates what the cell is going to do and how it's going to do it. Chromatin is the tangled, spread-out form of DNA found inside the nuclear membrane. When a cell is ready to divide, DNA condenses into structures known as chromosomes. The nucleus also contains a nucleolus, which is a structure where ribosomes are made.
What are the things that we learned today? We learn
after
about
ribosomes leave the nucleus, they will have the important job of synthesizing or making proteins.
That is nucleus. And also we learn about